you want for me to be for you tonight, honey? A good girl? Bad girl? Did I get rough?
You are such a tramp.
If you can't please your man, you shouldn't be allowed to have one.
There's no way these girls are from our school, man.
I would jump that.
I heard it's your birthday today.
Yeah, big 1-8.
Put me out.
I do not see what he sees in her.
My brother wants this to go well tonight. If you make me look bad, you two won't live to regret it.
Where is the weed?
On the trip, relax.
Within each of us lies the ability to do great good or great evil.
Do you want some?
What is it?
Make you feel really good.
I don't know.
Dude, they're dead.
What are you talking about?
They are upstairs, covered in blood, and it's a curse.
There's no curse. Oh my God.
Please don't leave me, Kyle.
Get out of here, Rachel.
This is not a joke.
It's not too late to turn around and run out of this house.
Now we can finally be together, Serena.
Ion Entertainment. Ion Entertainment.
We're here with Bill Oberst Jr., and he's one of the stars of The Devil Within. Your bio is amazing. Now, tell us how you got started.
I was a fat kid, and people made fun of me, and I wanted them to stop, so I found out that if I did impressions of my teachers and principals, they would not make fun of me, and so I learned the following useful equation, Donna, and it's really good. It will help you all throughout life. If you entertain people, they will not hit you. So my entire career has been begging people not to hit me.
Well, you know, I found an article that said that you said you were a fat kid, but I don't believe it. I mean,
I was huge. Immense. You could fill me up with hydrogen and I'd float away. I was huge.
Well, yeah. Then how did you lose it all?
Well, once people started liking me because I was acting, then I thought they might like me even more if I was not fat. And so then I got too skinny and now I can't go back. So I'm stuck. I'm the skinny, creepy guy.
Oh, well, you're in great shape. I just can't imagine you fat. So, okay. Now, you've been in theater forever, it seems like. You've done so much. Now, how did you get started on the stage?
It's all I ever wanted to do was act. And I speak a lot in schools to kids. And I tell them that I think that God gives everybody a gift, and the only gift I have is to pretend to be other people. And I thought stage was all I ever wanted to do, and I did it for 12 years in New York and toured, and it was great. And then I thought, well, I wonder what would happen if I did film. And so I came out to Hollywood and found out that I was scary. I had no idea. I really didn't know that I was scary before I came here.
I know, you look so nice.
Am I scary to you?
You've got beautiful blue eyes. No, I don't think you're scary at all. But you're from South Carolina then. And you went to the University of South Carolina.
I did, yes.
Okay, what did you study?
Theater. Yeah, theater. It's all I ever wanted to do.
So then when you went to the stage, you were already trained.
Yeah, but you know what? There's no way to get trained in stage or TV or film except doing it and making mistakes and falling on your ass. That's how you get trained.
Well, tell us about your first stage experience.
Well, it's an example of being trained. One of my first stage experiences was playing John F. Kennedy. I had really worked on the accent, you know, ask not what your country may do for you, but ask what you may do for your country, you know, this sort of thing, and had the full 1960s outfit. Anyway, I went on stage, it was a couple thousand people, and I was doing my thing, and this guy in the front row said, dude, your fly's down. So I learned, before you go on stage, you check, right?
So, what did you do? Did you zip it up?
I turned around, realized that the entire performance was ruined, discreetly zipped up and finished it. But I made a mental note. So you learn, you know. I'm not that bright, but I learn as I go along.
You must be bright to do the things you do. Okay, now, how did you get into this play about John Kennedy? Did you formulate it yourself?
I did. I'm a big fan of history, and I've always wondered what if you could go back and meet historical characters. So I played Mark Twain and John F. Kennedy and Abe Lincoln. I played Abe Lincoln for a while, but I was too short, and the kids laughed at me, so I stopped.
Well, tell us about your experience playing Jesus.
Thank you for asking that. Again, with historical characters, I wondered what if you could go back and actually meet people. And Jesus of Nazareth, or Rabbi Yeshua, is one of those people who I think it would be fascinating to actually hear these words for the very first time. And so I put together a presentation where I put on the look, as a first century Jewish rabbi would have, and just say the words that he said directly to people with no middleman. And I did it for 12 years and toured to many hundreds of churches, and it was quite fascinating and very meaningful to me.
You're a Christian yourself then?
I am. I thank God for every opportunity to do what I love for a living. I think it's the greatest gift. The worst thing in the world is to hate your job, you know, because you have to be at your job so much. And I get up every day and think, wow, I get the opportunity to do what I love for a living.
Well, tell me about your relationship with your mother. I noticed on your website you dedicated something to her. You must be really close.
You know what? My mama would love you, because I talked to her this morning and told her I was going to do this. And so I'm going to call her. I'm going to tell her that you ask about her, Donna. She's a lovely lady, and she always encouraged us to do whatever would make us happy. She doesn't particularly like the fact that I play all these scary guys. While I was filming The Devil Within, I called her, and she said, oh, what are you doing today, Billy? And I said, well, I got to kill a prostitute at 6 o'clock with an iron, which is the opening scene of The Devil Within. And she said, well, that's nice. Yeah, the weather's good here. You know, she kind of changes the subject. But Mom's okay. I'll let her see this film. She'll probably cover her eyes during the parts where I'm threatening and, you know.
Has she seen you be a killer before?
She has seen me be a killer before. I kill a lot of people, Donna. I kill a lot of women in particular. There seems to be this dynamic of a guy with a creepy face and a beautiful young girl. So I'm always with these creepy girls, you know, like stroking their hair and whispering to them. But they're always really nice. They say things like, get out of my light, you know, on the next take, you know, don't get my hair in my face. And I'm like, yes, ma'am, I'll take care of you. Liz DiPrinzio is really great in our scenes together. She let me, you know, be creepy. I had this scene where Randy, who was the producer, you know, reach out and do this kind of a hand thing. And she was really nice. She sat there and let me be creepy. So thank you, Liz.
You look so nice. Show us how you look creepy.
Creepy?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Can I lean in close? Do you mind?
Mm-hmm.
You get it here. So let's see. No, Donna. I'm really sorry that this had to happen. But it does. Like that.
Oh man, that's scary.
Creepy guy. I love creepy guy.
Are you like that at all?
Creepy guy puts peanut butter on my table, Donna. I'm happy to have him.
I mean, are you creepy at all in your real life? I mean, do you do that ever?
I go to bed at 9:30 at night. I sleep on sheets that have monkeys on them. Everybody says I'm the biggest dork in the world. I'm a huge Star Trek fan. I don't drink or smoke. I've never smoked marijuana. The things that people say, they say, oh, man, you must know all about, you know, meth. I don't even know what that is. So, I'm pretty dorky.
Yeah, he's great. Well, thank you so much for doing this interview with us. You have really penetrating eyes.
So do you, Donna. Thank you. And I want to tell your audience that before we started, I said, Donna, we've got to do a horror movie together. So either you kill me or I kill you. I don't really care. But as long as we work together, it'll be great.
Oh, I hope it happens. You know, Matt? Okay.
Thank you, Donna. It's a pleasure.
Thank you.
Ion Entertainment.
Yo-E.
entertainment.